Thank you so much, Rajesh ji, for welcoming me here on your wonderful platform, Make You Brand. And hello to all my audiences. So my name is Parul P. Agarwal. I am a professional tarot reader. I'm a numerologist. I'm also a past life healer, a switchword expert, crystal healer, and I'm also a teacher. I started my professional career in 2009. And I have been into these modalities for more than a decade. And I'm really blessed to have a diverse clientage and students from all across the globe.
Super. What was the motivation behind choosing this as your career?
See, the motivation behind this profession was simply my desire to make a difference in people's life. However small that may be, I always wanted to choose a profession that helped me to connect with people, lend a sympathetic ear to them, and also help people empower spiritually, because it gives me immense joy to actually be able to alleviate somebody's stress or sufferings, you know, to some extent through my modalities.
Okay, that's really great. So you're thinking of others. Very nice. So how you read the, you know, people's mind and people, you help people to find out their difficulties in life.
So basically, are you asking me what are the main, the unique points, or, you know, can you just tell me your question once again?
Yeah. How you use these techniques to help people?
Okay. So basically the thing is that in this profession, the main thing that is required is empathy. So I'm blessed because I'm a sensitive person by nature, and it comes very naturally to me to actually listen to people's issues and, you know, connect with them. People find it easy to relate with me and be their guide. Also, I believe in actually observing people, you know, knowing them and reading between their silences. I also, you know, because I'm genuinely interested in understanding why people behave the way they do. So that really helps me in my profession. Also, I believe in giving my 200% to everything, all my modalities. So that has not only helped my client, but it has also helped me personally and professionally, you know, to better my craft.
Great. Any success story you would like to share with us?
Okay, so being in this career for more than a decade, I've had my own share of highs and lows. But in every low, the only thing I did was never give up. I never gave up on my profession. I was consistent. And I also kept on investing in myself, in investing in my learning, kept learning new things. And the main turning point came in my career in around 2016, when I was first recognized for my efforts and my contribution to my field, and I was awarded the most aspiring tarot reader of the year. Not only that, after that I was listed and I appeared on various newspapers and magazines. I was featured in them. Also, I was given more recognitions and awards. So there has been no looking back since then.
Mm-hmm. Well, so tell us about your USPs, unique special points.
See, like I said, my unique selling point is my compassionate ability, the ability to feel deeply for others, the ability to be able to relate with others, and also the ability to give my 200% to everything I do.
Nice. So you basically help people, all your ability you apply to make him, you know, really motivated and successful. Really great.
See, Rajesh ji, it is said that a good healer is the one who can actually motivate someone to heal themselves. So my only focus always on whenever I take a session, my only focus is to empower people in such a way that they can help themselves. Because instead of making them dependent upon me, I believe in asking them to help themselves. Because that is how a person really grows. And learn from their life problems.
Very nice of you. Great. Any message you would like to give to our audience today?
Well, given the unprecedented times and the uncertain times we are living in, the only message I can think of right now is to have unwavering faith on the divine that indeed everything that is happening outside is in divine order. And I would like all the people to use this pandemic as an opportunity to not only connect with the creator, but also with your own self. Use this time to meditate and bring some peace, in this life, which is very important given the fact that we are living in very turbulent and unpredictable times. Okay. So be in gratitude of everything we have, and we should learn, this is the time we should learn to actually appreciate every little small thing that we have. So that's the only message I would like to give.
Very nice. Can you tell us your three wishes you want to still fulfill?
All right. Now, this is something nobody has ever asked me, and I never actually gave a thought about, three wishes that I would like to fulfill. So the only thing I can think quickly right now is the first wish would be to travel and explore this beautiful world. And second wish, I would like to maybe reach the pinnacle of my pinnacle of success in my career, in my field. Influence people in a most positive way. And last wish, I would like my family and my loved ones to be healthy, wealthy, and wise. So I guess that's about it.